How are you all doing, ladies and gentlemen? So it is official. Bayern have signed Lucas Hernandez for an 80 million euro fee. That's quite a lot of money, but it also signals that the intention to pay a lot of money this year is there. Now, Lucas Hernandez, he can of course play as a left back, primarily as a centre back. There's a lot of positions that he can play. It's actually quite astonishing that we signed him now. There were of course rumours early on during the winter transfer period saying that we would be likely to buy him. Well, it turns out that we now actually have bought him. We moved quite swift. I mean, we'd wanted him for the winter transfer period, according to the rumours, but it seemed like we've gotten him for the summer. So it's confirmed. It was officially confirmed about 10 minutes ago. Brilliant news, in my opinion, honestly. He is a player that has obviously a lot of quality, and obviously having someone like him and then Powered as well, who's obviously coming in summer, I say obviously quite a lot, but who's obviously who is coming in during the summer, having two players like that play together for the national team, for the French national team, and then having them come in as well and being obviously paired together for the Bayern squad is very good news. It seems that our squad is like slowly turning into like mainly French players, which I've got nothing against considering how well France have done lately. But like now we've got Pavard, who is obviously mainly a centre back and then can fill in for the left back role as well in case Alaba, you know, ever is injured or needs a rest or whatever. And Pavard, who can fill in that right back role. So we're basically covered for both left back and right back position as well. Obviously, both them covering the centre back position. It just shows you that, you know, we are actually serious. The words that Ole Hernandez was saying earlier on, where he was like, for a player like Lucas Hernandez, I'm willing to spend up to we're willing to spend up to 80 million euros. Well, we have now did it. He gets a 5-year contract. We have signed him for 80 million from Atletico Madrid. Honestly, I'm happy. I'm happy. I know a lot of people were like, we should go for other defenders. No, I mentioned it the first time we were linked with him. For me personally, he is the most, from the names mentioned, he is the most, I don't want to say the most talented, but he's the best at the moment. I know, you know, if a lot of people will disagree with me on that. They think that, you know, that we should have gone for a certain Ajax centre back. But I personally think that, you know, he and Pavard, they're going to be great for us. They're going to be, obviously, Pavard having a bit of a difficult season this year. But overall, I do think both of them will be very, very good for us. I feel like both of them will have a bright future ahead of them. They'll both do really, really well for Bayern. And honestly, the fact that we did it so early is a very promising sign. There's been a lot of rumors these past week, but I thought that was just like, I didn't make a video on it because I thought that was just like the basic, you know, we're on a break right now with the national team is playing. There's a club football break. So they're just, some newspapers are just trying to sell stuff. Well, it turns out, no, they weren't. Turns out that was actually genuine. And it turns out that we've actually signed him. So good job, Bayern. May continue. We've now filled our centre back. And left back and slash right back replacements or squad depth, I should say. More like so. We've now got left back and right back squad depth as well as centre back. Obviously there are certain positions that we still need to bolster. Depending, of course, on who leaves and who stays. But ideally, we need one more winger, potentially two. It really depends, but ideally we need at least one winger, potentially two, and perhaps one more midfielder. But that really depends on, yeah, that really depends on whether, you know, some of them will be leaving. With midfield, especially with Tolisso coming back, I do feel like it depends on if we're selling some of the midfielders that we have. But regardless, I'm happy. 5-year contract, 80 million euros, good fee. But for a good player, so I'm totally okay. That's funny that our highest fee ever so far was, who's the highest fee? I would say Tolisso, but Sanchez. I mean, I believe his performance bonuses were based on appearance. I think like 5 million every 25 appearances or so, and I'm pretty sure he's had, you know, 25 appearances so far. So he might have been I'm still assuming it's Tolisso at the moment. Maybe it's Renato Sanchez, but at this point, I believe it's still Tolisso. we just smashed that right out of the park. Doubled that fee. I think Talisa was like 41.5 million. Well, we just almost doubled that, you know. Yeah, it's like 41 million. Now we're buying. Now we're buying. And it's just interesting to see. But also, I'm happy, right? It's made my mood today quite good, all right? Anyway, folks, I will see you all for our next one, everybody. Until then, have a nice day and peace out. Bye.